Assalamu alaikum everyone, this is Vakas Ahmed. So today I'm going to show you the demo about setting up the Kubernetes cluster in the private, you know, public cloud like Google Cloud, Azure, and I will be using the VM, the host VM as Red Hat version 7. So you can just follow the same steps, you know, for create your own private cloud instead of using the GKE. I can go for the GKE, but the Kubernetes engine, but I thought, you know, just to show you step by step like how to create your own cloud cluster. So first of all, I'm going to click on the create instance. It will ask me to create the instance. Will give the name is as a master node. So this will be my master node, and I'm setting up master node in my East US region. The image I'm going to use for the master node will be Red Hat. Let me change the image. Red Hat Linux, and the version of Red Hat is 7. That's what I'm going to use. If I go down, I'm gonna place this Red Hat VM in the VPC, which is called front end VPC. So this master end will be on the front end. So done, and that's pretty much it. That's kind of simple. All you need to create the node. So this now, right now, my VM, the master node is creating. Let it give it some time. Let the master node be ready. Okay. So as soon as the master node is getting ready, what I will do, I will go ahead and I will try to create another VM instance for getting ready the worker node. Oh, master node is ready. Let's quickly log in to the master node. So it's kind of simple. All you click on the SSH and, you know, it will automatically transfer key and it will open this browser, small browser instance to connect to your VM. You can also use the PuTTY on your VM, you know. Just download the key, private key from there, use that private key, connect to your instance. So right now I'm just using this browser instance to SSH my VM. So it's connecting. Okay, once I am in, so let's first install the update, if there is any kind of update. Yeah, okay, so I'm changing the mode and yum, install update. This will go ahead and install all the required update. Meanwhile, since installing the update, what I will do, I will again go to the my instance. Once I'm in my instance, I will launch one more instance. So it's kind of simple to launch your instance from the computer instance. You will click this create instance, and this time I'm going to create the instance called worker node because I have my master node. Master node need the worker node. So kind of same configuration. I'm going to paste this worker node in the same region where the master node is, which is East US 1. And the worker node, the OS for the worker node, I'm also using the Red Hat Linux. So I'm using Red Hat, the version is Red Hat 7, select. And the networking part where I'm gonna put this, so I will be putting in the same VM, VPC where the master node is, which is a front end VPC. Okay, so done and create. So now the worker node is creating. Let's check the master node if it's still installing. So master node is still installing the update. If I look at the worker node, so worker node is ready. Okay, so when you are setting up the cluster, you need to download some repository like Kubeadm command, and for Kubeadm command you need to configure your yum repo. So I already, you know, if I show you, you can go to the Kubernetes official document, you know, installing that document. It will give you the different operating system, how to set up the yum repo. So I'm just setting up the yum repo for my Red Hat instance. So let it complete. It's still installing the updates on my master node. My worker node is getting ready. Okay, let's give it a few more seconds. Let's check the, let me stop the, okay, so it is done, you know. Let me clear, let me configure the repos. Repo has been configured. So let me clear again. First of all, you know, before installing that, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna disable the SE Linux. It is, you know, required to set the SE Linux in the permissive mode just for the Kubernetes configuration. So I have set up my, and also what I'm gonna do just for the installation, I'm gonna disable the firewall. I don't want to be in something, you know, get the rules and whatever. So let me check the status again. Systemctl status firewall D. So you can see the firewall is inactive now. I have disabled the firewall and I have disabled the SE Linux just for the easier. So you know, if you're compatible with the firewall and if you're compatible with SE Linux, you can just reconfigure this as per your own. So I'm ready. So first of all, before installing the Kubernetes cluster, you need to install the runtime engine. I'm gonna use the runtime engine called Docker. So let me install Docker. So I will say I'm install Docker. Yes, go. So what it will do, it will go ahead and install the Docker runtime engine on your Kubernetes, because for the Kubernetes cluster you need the runtime engine, which can be either Docker, which can either be cryo, which can either be container. I'm just using compatible with Docker, so I'm just, you know, if you're compatible with cryo or container, you can go ahead with that specific one. So let me download. So it's currently it's downloading the packages and then it will go. Okay, now the Docker is complete, installation is complete. So how can you check if the Docker is installed now? You can just simply click Docker and maybe info, it will give you the complete info. Okay, need to install the services. So it's gonna be systemctl enable, and what I'm gonna enable, Docker now. Okay, so it's enabling the Docker. Once it is enabled, let's again check info. Now you can see that Docker is installed, you know, you see all the Docker, like it says Docker info, Docker is installed, the Docker version. If you want to check, you can just type Docker version, which Docker version is installed. So check the Docker version. So that's the local Docker version, client version, and server version installed. So we are good at this point. So we installed. Now the next command is what we need to do. We need to set up the Kubeadm. Kubeadm is a tool which will set up the cluster for you. And while installing the Kubeadm, you have to give this flag that disable the Kubernetes. I will explain later why I'm doing this. So what I'm gonna do, I will say okay, yum install. I'm gonna show you one thing while installing this. I said yum install and Kubeadm, and I give this flag disable Kubernetes. So it's going ahead. Try to search for the Kubeadm. I already configured the repo, that's why it showed this repo. Now if you look at the dependency, it's installing the kubelet and kubectl, which is required for the cluster. So that's good. Let me say yes, and it's now going ahead and installing Kubeadm. Okay, so Kubeadm has been installed. Now you can see the dependency which I have installed. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to start systemctl and enable kubelet. So I say kubelet now, and the kubelet is a start. Let me check the status, systemctl status, kubelet. If you look at this, it says activating. It's not activated because, you know, still we need to configure something else. So let me clear this one. Now Kubeadm is there. So what we're gonna do, we will go to the Kubeadm. It's already there. And to the Kubeadm, I will say, okay, Kubeadm, configure images pull. So I'm just pulling the images which will be required for setting up the cluster. So it will go ahead and start pulling up the images, which is good. Like it will do it itself, but I'm just gonna show you like what images. So it's pulling up API servers, pulling control manager, scheduler, proxy, etcd. So these are all the required component for the cluster, you know, master node, which will be set up on the master node. So it says completed. Okay, now actual command is kubeadm initialize. So that gonna, but I'm gonna show you some help. If you go to the okay, I just mistyped. So if I go to the kubeadm initialize, it says okay, there are multiple flags you can give the kubeadm. While setting up the kubeadm, what I want to do, I want to set up the port slider. What exactly the port slider it's gonna use? If you look, there are multiple, you know, container runtime engine. If you want to cryo, flannel, I'm going for with the flannel. And if you look to the flannel, the IP address is claim that flannel network use gonna be somewhere here and there. See 10.224.0.0.16. That's what I'm gonna use the IP address scheme. So I will use this flag while installing Kubeadm. So I would say Kubeadm. Let me clear this first. I would say Kubeadm. Initialize my container and use this port slider and enter. It will go ahead generate some certificates. I will explain later why the certificates are needed, and it's setting up your cloud. Pretty good. So let me just stop the recording, and when it will be done, I will start the recording again. Thanks. Okay guys, so I'm back. So if you see, it has successfully installed the Kubeadm, you know, it already configured it. So first of all, you need to start your cluster by running following command. I will explain later why the following commands are needed. It will copy the config file to your home directory. And so it's pretty much done. Now there is one more command, you know, for which will be need to joining the worker node. So copy this command maybe somewhere. You can recreate this command, you know. Some people think if you just forward this command, it will be like disaster. So let me show you. If you clear this one, if I say, okay, kubeadm join. First of all, let me show you the token list. This is the token list, and you can also say kubeadm create. And let me take some help. I don't remember the command. Print join. So I will say kubeadm and print the join command for me. In case you know you don't remember the command, maybe sometime later you want to join some other worker node. So here you go. This is what you're gonna use to join your worker node. So what I will do, I will quickly go ahead, connect to my worker node, and I will try to join my worker node to this. So this is worker node 1. I'm going to open in my browser. So before installing the worker node, okay, worker node also need the Docker, because worker node will be without the Docker, worker node can't run the containers on itself. And worker node also need the kubeadm. Kubeadm is required for joining the master node. And worker node also need kubelet. Kubelet also, you know, keeps where to set up the, like, it coordinate with the master node. So first of all, let me cm install update. If there is any pending update, you're gonna install. Okay, so it needs the privileges. I clear this one. I say okay again, yum install update, and it's installing the update. So let me stop the video and let me complete it. Alright, so guys, it's done with the update. Let me clear this one. So what I'm gonna do two things. First of all, I will disable the SE Linux just to be in privacy mode, which is recommended. So I'm gonna go to my worker node, just paste this command, and it will disable the SE Linux for me. Second thing I'm gonna do, I will systemctl and disable the firewall. So I will be disabling firewall D now. So just to confirm, ctl status firewall D, and you can see it's in active mode, firewall D. So looks good. Let me configure the repo. Otherwise, without configuring the repo, it will not be able to find the kubeadm. So let me configure repo. Repo configured, beautiful. So let me clear this one. Now let's install first of all the container runtime engine, which gonna be Docker. Yes, installing the Docker now. So let me just stop for a while and let it complete. Okay guys, so Docker has been installed successfully. The next thing we're gonna do is, let me clear this thing. So now I'm going to go ahead and I will install the kubeadm. Install kubeadm. And remember, before installing the kubeadm, we give a flag, disable the exclude Kubernetes. So I'm going to give the same flag too. And you know, like kubeadm will install the kubelet and kubectl. So I'm just saying why to yes. So everything will be, I don't need to say yes again. Alright guys, so you can see it's done now. So let me clear this thing. Now just let me enable the services. So two services I'm gonna enable. The first service will be Docker, which we just installed in front of you guys. And the other service I'm gonna install for this one will be kubectl. So these two services are installing. Let me see the status, kubectl, status, Docker, okay, status. So Docker is running. Let me show the kubelet. Okay, kubelet is trying to activate, no problem. Let me clear this one. So the thing I'm gonna do on this worker node will be simple, this like kube join. So I will paste kube join on the worker node. You can see it's a worker node 1, and I will hit enter. It does some flight checks and it will be joining, trying to wait. Okay, okay, it's joined. So it's saying just do kubelet get nodes to see if it is joined or not. So I'm going to go to the master node. This is my master node. You can see, let me clear this one. And if I show you the host name, so you see master node. This is a master node. So on the master node, I will say kubectl get node. Okay, typo. So you see worker node is there. The worker node is there, but it says the status is not ready. Why it says not ready? Because if I go to the kubectl, kubectl get ports, and if I say see some port running in the kube system, so you see there are two ports, which is CodeDNS and CodeDNS, and they are in the pending state. It's not running. So but why it's not running? Because there's some kind of networking problem going on right now. So I told you there are some install add-ons. I'm going to install the add-ons Flannel. Flannel is a network I'm going to use in this demonstration. So this is, you know, this is the link from you can download the Flannel. So I'm copying this, just this link for Kubernetes, and I'm going to run this on the master node. So I come to the master node, I paste, oops. So that's legacy. I'm going to remove legacy. Small change I'm going to make will be manifest file. Okay, so it says created. Now if I just run the same command again, the node one, get the port, you see it created some more port. It's called Flannel. So it's created two Flannel. One Flannel is for the master and the second Flannel port is for the other one, the worker node. If you have two worker nodes, when it create three Flannel number, depend upon the number of the nodes running. And it's right now pending. Let me again do so. See, all of them is running now. Everything is running now. So let me clear this one. So now the internet looks good. Kubectl and get nodes. If I again type, okay, I'm so bad. It's gonna be kubectl. It's not QADM. So kubectl get node, and see both is ready. Even if I say this open wide, it will show you like the IP addresses. So see, that's the beauty of the Kubernetes cluster. Now what I can do, I can just create thousands of the node, and you know, just join then this join command to those thousand of the node, and every node will be the part of this collector. Thank you so much for staying with me, guys. I hope to see you again. Thank you. Allah Hafiz. Bye bye.